Hello, good morning, everyone. On today's program, we want to start looking at the third topic on the director of photography. Last week, we had the opportunity to be able to look into the production process. And when we were looking into the production process, we basically looked into when one comes up with an idea, which particular process does he or she take it through before finally we have that finished product, which is a program, so that one can be able to view it, or one can be able to have it on DVD or on CD, so that it can be viewed by his or our audience at home. Now, as we were talking about that, we did look into the five stages of production. That's the first school of thought. And we also looked into the three stages of production, which is actually the school of thought. And when we were looking into that, we saw why should one be able to have his idea be subjected into the five stages of production, or be subjected into three stages of production. And as we were looking into this, we believe that everybody did understand exactly why do we have such kind of a separation, that you can be able to have five stages of production and no three stages of production, or why is it that you can be able to have three stages of production and not five stages of production? And as we were looking at that, we saw at each every stage what normally happens there. When you talk about development, what is it that we have? When you move from development, you move to pre-production, you move from pre-production, you move to production. From production, you get into post-production. From post-production, you move into distribution and sales. Now, when you talk about those particular stages, we again did talk about the various activities that are done there by various individuals, and what these particular individuals exactly do, so that we could be able to know exactly, we as cinematographers, when do we come in, and when we come in, what are these particular things that we actually get to do. So today, we want to move from that particular level and talk about director of photography. And as we talk about director of photography, there's no way we can be able to talk about it if we can't be able to go back and look into the second topic that we had discussed. Now, the director of photography is basically the principal photographer, basically the cinematographer. Now, when you talk about the cinematographer, this is the person who engages himself or herself in mostly in the production stage, and is the one who is in charge of translating what has been arranged and designed by production designer and the director into raw footage that can be edited. And if one is going to be at home, seated and watching it, he or she could be able to see the story that was on the script and was on set. And now it's something that has been compacted together, packaged together, and put in a particular manner that he or she can be able now to be able to view it from home and appreciate it, that this is a good production. Now, how does one be able to achieve this? Now, a director photographer will be able to be engaged in the pre-production stage, during the production, and after production. Now, one thing that you get to realize that the director of photography is one person in many other things. And when I say one person in many other things, what we are trying to say is that this particular individual needs to be able to understand what will happen or what is supposed to happen during the construction of the set, during the selection and scouting of the set, during the process of designing costumes, during in the process of decisions in terms of the kind of paintings that are going to be done. He is actually the person who is going to be in charge in writing. He's the person who is going to be in charge of understanding during the rehearsal processes, what are the various movements that are how are they going to happen? So these are things that you actually need to be able to, and for us to be able to move from one point to the other, I want to share with you on this particular notes that I have here, so that you can be able to understand exactly when this person does what he or she does. When does he or she get to do one or two things, and how do these things happen? So this one here, let me up there. That you can do look. So what I want us to be able to look into is these responsibilities. What are the responsibilities of the director?
Not bad. Me caes? You have joined the audio conference. Oh, I go to. It's
I'm You are currently the only person in this conference. You are currently the only person in this conference. You are currently the only person in this conference. You are currently the only person. You are currently the only person in this conference. You are currently the only person in this conference. You are currently the only person in this conference. You are currently the only person in this conference. You are currently the only person in this conference. You are currently the only person in this conference. You are currently the only person in this conference.
Hello, Grace.
You are currently the only person in this conference.
Dennis. Hello? Dennis.
Yes. Yes. Hello?
I'm good and then Pata.
Yeah, I'm good, Pata.
You followed what we have been discussing about from the beginning?
Yes, actually, I was just looking at the notes.
Mm-hmm.
And currently, I have notes on the film making process. That is what I'm looking at right now.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why I have not responded to the chat you just handed.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but actually I'm proceeding well.
Okay, that's great.
Yeah.
Okay. Now,
And then I also
Hello.
Yes, I have a question on the catch you did before we started the.
Mm-hmm. Hello. Dennis. Una katakata. Mundi. Grace. Grace. Hello, Grace. Okay, we are going to stop at this particular point in time, and it's my hope that what we have discussed today about the director of photography, you will keenly follow it up. If there will be a question, no problem, get in touch with me. I will be able to answer that. Now, I'm posting the notes on the portal, on the Moodle, that is. If you have a question, like I've said, do not hesitate to ask that particular question. And there's an assignment that I'm actually posting there. You can work on it and before the class ends. Have a very nice morning and enjoy yourselves.